Good morning, everyone. Please post your doubts. Let's begin with solving your doubts. So quickly post your doubts on the chat box. Let's solve that first. Then we go to the most important section of this accounting standard, research and development. Quickly check everything that we have done. If you have any doubts, please post them. Let's first solve your doubts. Then we proceed to the next part of the accounting standard. Okay, I have one doubt which says question number 8, the second part. Let me check that. Okay, question number 8, second part. Right, so please understand this second part in question number 8. It means that at the end of the third year, you found that the intangible will now not be of any use, which means third year ke baad intangible ki life खत्म हो जाएगी क्योंकि थर्ड ईयर के बाद इंटेंजिबल की लाइफ खत्म हो जाएगी. एंटायर अमाउंट विल गो टू द प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट. यू कैन नॉट अमोर्टाइज इट इन द फोर्थ ईयर. सो यू विल थिंक इन दिस वे कि थर्ड ईयर में तुम मुझे 30 अमोर्टाइज करना ही है ये वाला एट द एंड ऑफ द थर्ड ईयर. पर 30 के साथ साथ मुझे 15 भी अमोर्टाइज कर देना पड़ेगा क्योंकि नेक्स्ट ईयर फोर्थ ईयर में वी विल नॉट बी हैविंग एनी यूजफुल लाइफ ऑफ द इंटेंजिबल. Because we won't be having any useful life of the intangible in the fourth year, we amortize 15 also at the end of the third year. So the total of the two will come to 45. Right, so this is how you solve the second part of question number 8. Right, Anjali, I hope that solves your doubt. Okay. There is one more doubt which says in question number 9, if the company comes to know at the end of 5 years that intangible is useful for further 1 year, not yet clear. Okay, let me understand what you're trying to ask. Okay, so in question number 9, you are saying that at the end of the 5th year, what I'll do is I'll try and solve this question for you. Let's solve it properly for you. Okay. Let's keep it this way. Okay, Spruha, help me with the values. Tell me, what's your amortization ratio over here? Quickly on your chat box. You have 0.25. Then over here, 100 divided by 800 will be 0.25. Okay, please write on the chat box. Do you want the change to be at the end of the 4th year or at the end of the 5th year? Do you want it to be at the end of the 4th year? Okay, at the end of the 5th year, right? So you'll have to write this as well. 0.125. Okay, what's your value of intangible in the question? What is your value of intangible in the question? $400 lakhs. Let's try and put it 400 into 0.25. you get 100 100 100. You have 400 into 0.125 50 50. So entire 400 lakhs will be amortized at the end of the fifth year. Now in the sixth year, tell me how much extra amount do you want? What's your new value or new estimated cash flow? 50? Okay, let's take 50. Now tell me, for how many more years will this intangible work? For how many more years will this intangible work? Only 1 year? Okay, so you will have 1 over here. You will have 1 over here. How much have you already amortized to the profit and loss account? 400 lakhs. So how much are you left out with now? What is the unamortized portion? What is the unamortized portion? Zero. In fact, can I say after the addition of the sixth year, the unamortized portion is 50? You agree with that? The unamortized portion right now is 50. Yes or no? So after the end of the fifth year, which year is left? After the end of the fifth year, which year is left? Sixth year. Sixth year is the only year that is left, right or wrong? Yes. So in the sixth year, what's your value? ₹50 lakh. Have you amortized 50 lakhs? No. So then 50 lakhs becomes your unamortized value, the value that is left yet to be amortized. So this entire 50 lakhs will be charged to the profit and loss account or amortized in the sixth year. That's it. So for the sixth year, your own unamortized value will be 50, and that will go to the profit and loss account. Right. I hope you're clear with that. Please quickly check and put it on the chat box. So now the value of your intangible has become zero. So that's the only choice that you will have. So because you will take one over here and the value will be zero. So technically, okay, the value will be zero. I'm sorry, my mistake. The value will be zero. You will not amortize anything because your entire value of intangible has now become zero. Okay. I'm sorry, I missed that. Expected cash flows. That was my mistake. Anyways, this value will be zero and your unamortized value will be 400. Okay. I hope that solves your doubts, Pruva. Okay. Thank you. Anyone else who has a doubt, let's quickly solve it and then we proceed with the next part. Okay, I guess all doubts are done. So let's go to the next part. Come to page number 174. Come to page number 174. Come to page number 174. Page number 174. Let's understand this. residual value. ES 26 assumes that the residual value of the intangible is always nil. Underline this. ES 26 says कि intangible को usually आप end में sell नहीं कर पाओगे, तो उसकी residual value हमेशा क्या आएगी? Nil आएगी. The residual value of the intangible will always be nil. Important point. The residual value will always be nil. It is presumed to be always nil. Unless, ध्यान देना, any third party has committed to purchase the asset under, underline, binding contract of sale. Binding contract of sale मतलब अगर contract हो गया तो खरीदना ही पड़ेगा और आपको बेचना ही पड़ेगा. That is known as a binding contract of sale. So if a third party has committed to purchase the asset under a binding contract of sale, then definitely you will have a residual value. Or there is an active secondary market. Underline this, active secondary market. Active secondary market means a market where you can sell second hand goods. That is known as your secondary market. The one from which you directly purchase fresh or new goods is known as primary market. The one which involves second hand purchase and sale is known as the secondary market. So residual value of an intangible is always assumed to be nil. However, it will not be nil in two circumstances. One, any third party has committed to purchase the asset under a binding contract of sale. Or there is an active secondary market where the residual value can be estimated reliably. So unless until you have any one of these two conditions getting satisfied, you will always have residual value of an intangible to be nil. Right, okay, that was a simple point. Come to the next one, the most important point, treatment of research and development. Now this you need to be very careful with and you need to understand. There are two words that they are talking about. The first one that they say is research, and the other one is development. Can someone tell me on the chat box, what is the meaning of research? Can you explain to me what is the meaning of research? Quickly, someone on the chat box, what is the meaning of research? Research means trying to innovate something. Okay, anyone else? The study that you undertake. Okay, can I say research means trying to check feasibility of a particular new thing? Everyone on your chat box, yes or no? We are trying to check कि जो भी नई चीज हम करना चाहते हैं क्या वो successful होगी, उस पर हम research करते हैं. Everyone agrees? We are trying to check the feasibility of a particular new thing. That is known as what? Your research. Now please understand what used to happen was, and please understand this properly because it has dual concepts, so please pay attention. If you understand the Income Tax Act, and someone will teach you in the Income Tax Act 1961, in a chapter known as PGBP, someone will teach you that you get weighted deduction. Now please understand what is weighted deduction. मान लीजिए अगर आप रिसर्च करते हैं और आपने 100 रुपए खर्च किए, तो गवर्नमेंट आपको 150 रुपीज का डिडक्शन देगी. डिडक्शन मतलब दिस मच यू विल डेबिट टू प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट. आई एम राइटिंग ओवर हियर, डेबिट टू प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट. ओके, टेल मी ऑन द चैट बॉक्स, व्हाट विल हैपन व्हेन यू डेबिट टू पीएनएल? विल योर प्रॉफिट इंक्रीज और रिड्यूस? क्विकली ऑन द चैट बॉक्स, विल योर प्रॉफिट इंक्रीज और रिड्यूस व्हेन यू डेबिट टू पीएनएल? विल योर प्रॉफिट इंक्रीज और रिड्यूस? Of course, it will reduce. Okay, please pay attention. If your profit reduces, tax to be paid will be more or less? Tax to be paid will be more or less? Of course, it will be less. Which means if someone, please understand, if someone is doing research expenditure, पहला बेनिफिट तो ये है कि सीधा वो एक्सपेंस पीएनएल में डेबिट हो जाएगा और आपका उतना टैक्स पोर्शन कम आएगा। दूसरा, कितनी बार ये लोग टैक्स बेनिफिट वेटेड डिडक्शन के तौर पे देते हैं। सो यू हैव 100 रुपीज एंड 150 रुपीज यू विल गेट एज डिडक्शन। नाउ अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल यूज टू मिस यूज दिस, दे अननेसेसरली यूज टू शो रिसर्च एक्सपेंसेस एंड देन ट्राई एंड क्लेम एक्स्ट्रा बेनिफिट्स फ्रॉम द इनकम टैक्स, राइट? In order to stop all these, a lot of actions were taken. But then Accounting Standard 26 was very clear. They were very clear in one fundamental. And that fundamental is that research is not a guarantee. Dhyan dena. They said research is not a guarantee that you will have a new asset. गारंटी है कि रिसर्च सक्सेसफुल होगा और सक्सेसफुल होने पे न्यू एसेट आएगा, विच मींस देयर आर नो चांसेस दैट देयर आर वेरी लेस चांसेस और यू आर नॉट श्योर वेदर एन एसेट विल बी क्रिएटेड और नॉट। सो देन द अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड बोर्ड सेड रिसर्च इज ओनली न्यू फाइंडिंग्स एंड दैट इज व्हाई एनी रिसर्च एक्सपेंस विल डायरेक्टली गो टू द प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट। आर यू गेटिंग इट? फिर से समझा रहा हूं, उन्होंने ऐसा कहा कि रिसर्च चांस है कि आपको कुछ नया मिलेगा, चांस है कि शायद आपको कोई नई इंटेंजिबल एसेट भी मिलेगी, मगर चांस है, श्योरिटी नहीं है। क्योंकि श्योरिटी नहीं है, आप एक काम करो, आप रिसर्च एक्सपेंस को सीधा सीधा पीएनएल में डाल दो, उसको इंटेंजिबल की तरह क्रिएट करने की जरूरत नहीं है, उसको डिफर करने की जरूरत नहीं है। रिसर्च एक्सपेंस जहां पे भी दिखे सीधा कहां पे चले जाएगा? प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट। आर यू गेटिंग इट? अगेन आई एम रिपीटिंग फॉर यू, we are understanding the concept of research and development in accounting standard 26, where accounting standard 26 is very clear that any expense on research is not a guarantee that you will have a new asset. You may have, you may not have. Since it is not a guarantee, let's charge the entire research expense to the profit and loss account. Let's not claim it as an intangible asset. Are you getting it? Okay, come to the next one. There is another word which says development. Now, these two words are always used together, research and development, popularly known as R&D, which means research and development. Lekin AS26 ne isko do part mein tod diya. One is research, one is development. Can someone on the chat box tell me what is the meaning of development? Can someone on the chat box tell me in the context of research and development, in the context of research and development, what is the meaning of development? Can someone put that on the chat box, that in the context of research and development, what is actually development? Okay, I have one answer which says something new has been invented. Okay, then it says to increase the efficiency. Third, it says to make something with improved features. And fourth is improvement in product. Now, please understand. I will explain to you what is research and development. So please pay attention. Okay, I have one more answer which says to develop some idea to implement the thing you research or to improve something. Further research into something in order to get the improved product. Okay, this is close. Implementation of successful research, this is also close. So last three answers were a bit close, but please understand what happens. Suppose if I want to find out that, suppose if I decide that I will start a new business, my new business will be manufacturing cars that run on electricity. Right, dhyan dena. My objective is to manufacture cars that will run on electricity. Now, first thing is feasibility. Kya ye possible hai? Do type ki feasibility hoti hai. Technical एंड इकोनॉमिकल। पहली बार क्या ये टेक्निकली पॉसिबल है? चलो ये टेक्निकली पॉसिबल है, यस। इकोनॉमिकली पॉसिबल है, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इकोनॉमिक फिजिबिलिटी? इट मींस ऐसा ना हो कि जितना पैसा पेट्रोल का बचता है उससे दो गुना ज्यादा महंगी ये कार है, फिर कोई खरीदेगा नहीं। फिर लोग यही कहेंगे कि ये नई कार खरीद के भी ज्यादा खर्चा ही हो रहा है, इससे अच्छा तो हमारा पेट्रोल वाला कार ही सही है। विच मीन्स यू विल हैव टू कंपेयर बोथ टेक्निकल एंड इकोनॉमिकल फिजिबिलिटी। नाउ व्हेन बोथ दीज फिजिबिलिटीज आर बीइंग चेक्ड, यू आर अगेन नॉट श्योर whether this will result in an intangible or not. So again, you will consider this as a research. Next point पे ध्यान देना। अगर आपको पता चलता है कि हाँ ऐसी कार बन सकती है और economically भी ये कार feasible है, ऐसी कार बननी चाहिए, सस्ती भी पड़ेगी और technically sound भी है, then what you will try to do is, जो आपने on paper research का plan बनाया है वो आप प्रैक्टिकली अप्लाई करने की कोशिश करोगे। यू विल ट्राई द प्रैक्टिकल एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द सेम, एंड एनी प्रैक्टिकल एप्लीकेशन ऑफ रिसर्च इज नोन एज डेवलपमेंट। आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग? एनी प्रैक्टिकल एप्लीकेशन ऑफ रिसर्च इज नोन एज व्हाट? डेवलपमेंट। राइट, अगेन आई एम रिपीटिंग फॉर यू, व्हेन यू आर ट्राइंग टू फाइंड आउट some new ways or you're trying to invent something new, something innovative, then it is known as a research. You are trying to innovate, you have not innovated. When you try to innovate, it is known as research. On the other hand, when you decide that the research stage is done and it is successful and now we want to further develop this research, we want to materialize this research, then that stage is known as the development stage. Accounting standard 26 is very clear that any expense pertaining to research will directly go to the profit and loss account. Development, we will allow you to capitalize subject to 6 conditions. मतलब अगर आपने 6 condition हमारी satisfy कर ली, all 6 conditions की बात कर रहा हूँ, not any one. अगर आपने 6 condition हमारी satisfy कर दी, तो हम आपको allow करेंगे कि आप development expenditure भी capitalize करोगे और intangible create करोगे. लेकिन research कोई दिन आप नहीं कर सकते, रिसर्च विल डायरेक्टली गो टू द प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट। आर यू गेटिंग इट? क्विकली ऑन द चैट बॉक्स, इज दैट क्लियर टू यू, यस और नो? सो क्विकली ऑन द चैट बॉक्स, इज दैट क्लियर टू यू, यस और नो? ओके एवरीवन, क्विकली ऑन द चैट बॉक्स, is this clear to you, yes or no? Okay, since this is clear to you, let's try and understand what they've given. Dhyan dena. Treatment of research and development. Research expense should be charged to revenue as and when incurred. Underline this. It will be charged to revenue as and when incurred. So please underline this. It will straight away go to the profit and loss account. Come to the next one, development. What is development? Development is application of research findings. Jo bhi research mein aapne dhoonda hai, ab aap usko materialize karoge, ab aap usko apply kar rahe ho. Why are you applying research findings to plan and design the new business techniques? So what is development? It is application of research findings to plan and design the new business techniques. Development expenditure can be capitalized if, very important, all the following are satisfied. Development expenditure can be capitalized only if all the following are satisfied. So all need to be satisfied. All the following should be satisfied. Development expenditure can be capitalized if all the following conditions are satisfied, right? So research cannot be capitalized, will go to the profit and loss account. Development can be capitalized only if all the 6 conditions are satisfied. First condition, dhyan dena. Technical feasibility has been established. Matlab technically possible hai ki ye asset ban sakta hai. If technical feasibility has been established, only then you will capitalize development expenditure. Second point. Firm has the intention, very important word, intention to use or sell the asset. Underline that. फर्म के पास क्या होना चाहिए, इंटेंशन, मतलब हम ये इंटेंजिबल बना के सिर्फ रख नहीं देंगे, या तो हम इसको बेचेंगे या तो हम इसको यूज करेंगे. राइट नाउ एवरीवन ऑन द चैट बॉक्स, दे हैव यूज्ड द वर्ड यूज और सेल. ओके, कैन समवन टेल मी ऑन द चैट बॉक्स, यस और नो से बताना, इफ वी सेल द इंटेंजिबल असेट विल वी गेट मनी, यस और नो? Yes, of course we will get money. Because we are selling and we are getting money, can I say future economic benefits are available from the intangible? Yes or no? Of course, yes. Future economic benefits are available. Because future economic benefits are available and an intangible must have future economic benefits, that is why this condition has been inserted. Okay, firm should have the ability, the intention to use or sell. If you have the intention to sell, you will have future economic benefits. ओके, ध्यान देना. मान लीजिए मैं 1000 रुपए की कोई चीज बाहर से खरीदता हूं. आई परचेज एन आइटम ऑफ 1000 एंड आई यूज इट इन प्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस. नाउ आई फील दैट रादर देन बाइंग फ्रॉम आउटसाइड आई शुड रिसर्च एंड मैन्युफैक्चर इट इन हाउस. इफ आई मैन्युफैक्चर इट इन हाउस माई कॉस्ट कम्स टू 400 एंड दिस 400 आई एम पुटिंग इन द प्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस. I want everyone on the chat box to tell me when I am reducing my cost of purchase from 1000 to 400, am I reducing my cost? Am I reducing my expenditure? Yes or no? Okay. One more question I have. If I say that I am reducing my cost or I am reducing my expenditure, will that increase my revenue by any means? Yes or no? खर्चा कम होता है तो रेवेन्यू भी बढ़ता है. यस, अगेन कैन आई से आई एम गोइंग टू हैव फ्यूचर इकोनॉमिक बेनिफिट्स. अगेन आई विल से दैट आई हैव फ्यूचर इकोनॉमिक बेनिफिट्स. सो अगेन फर्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट कंडीशन, टेक्निकल फीजिबिलिटी शुड बी एस्टेब्लिश. टेक्निकली ऐसा पॉसिबल होना चाहिए कि ये बन सकता है. टेक्निकल फीजिबिलिटी होगी तो ही आप उसको डेवलप कर पाओगे, वरना डेवलप नहीं कर पाओगे. Second important point, firm should have the intention to use or sell the intangible asset. हमारे पास intention होना चाहिए कि हम इसको बना के बेच देंगे या हम इसको बना के internally use करेंगे. Third point, देखो मेरा intention तो है कि मैं बहुत बड़ा aircraft बनाऊँ. मेरा intention तो है कि मैं बहुत बड़ा ship बनाऊँ. मेरा intention तो है कि मैं बहुत बड़ी machine बनाऊँ. मेरा intention तो बहुत कुछ है. But do I have the ability to do it? What is the meaning of ability? Ability means, do I have the resources to do it? Do I have the finance to do it? Do I have the technical team to execute this operation? Right, I may have the intention to do anything and everything, but am I fully equipped with resources? Do I have the ability to use or sell the asset is your next important point. Now, please understand both is important. First is intention. Second is ability. I'm writing both the words. दोनों होना जरूरी है. कई बार क्या होता है, मेरे पास intention है लेकिन ability नहीं है. कई बार ability है लेकिन intention नहीं है. तो दोनों में से कोई भी एक भी नहीं होगा तो काम नहीं होगा आपका. इसलिए दोनों होना जरूरी है. The firm should have the intention and the firm should have the ability to use or sell the intangible asset. Are you getting it? Again, let's quickly revise the first 3 points. It says, first, technical feasibility has been established. Second, firm has the intention to use or sell the asset. Third, firm has the ability to use or sell the asset. सबसे पहले आना चाहिए intention, फिर आता है ability. So, technical feasibility has been established. The firm should have intention to use or sell the asset. The firm should have the ability to use or sell the asset. Fourth point, dhyan dena. I'm writing it over here. My question to you is, say for example, just give me a minute. Let me think for an easier example for you. Okay, since right now the economy is down. Right now the economy is down. Please understand that. You have some kind of crisis in this economy. And if you say that within the city people use car, rather than using car, people should use aircraft. You feel there is a market right now that people will buy aircraft for local transportation, yes or no? Of course not. Okay. One more point. You have the intention to build, sell and sell the aircraft. You have the intention to build and sell the aircraft. You also have the ability to build and sell the aircraft. You have the intention, you have the ability. But my question to you is there a market? Yes or no? Is there a market where you can sell the product? Of course, it is not there. That's your fourth point. There should be a market for the final product. Or if the intangible asset, or if the firm wants to use it internally, its usefulness should be demonstrated. Matlab sabse pehle, agar aap bechna chahte ho, there should be a market for either the final product or the intangible asset. Or if you want to use it internally, you have to demonstrate its usefulness. Are you understanding? You will have to demonstrate its usefulness. Right, again, first point. Technical feasibility should be established. The firm should have the intention to use or sell the asset. The firm should have the ability to use or sell the asset. Lekin ability, intention, bechne ka tab hoga jab market hoga. There should be a market for the final product or the intangible asset. Or if it is to be used internally, the usefulness should be demonstrated. Are you getting it? The usefulness should be demonstrated. Right, these are your first four points. Fifth point, again, everyone on the chat box, please pay attention. I have one question for you. My question to you is very clear. And my question is, please pay attention. My question is, in order to create an intangible, or in order to get the asset ready for its use, or in order to make the asset saleable, or in order to make the asset to be used internally, is it important only to start the work, or it is also important that we must be able to finish the work? Tell me, sirf start karna hi zaruri hai ya finish karna bhi bahut zaruri hai if you want to create an intangible? Quickly on the chat box. We must be able to, of course, we must be able to finish the work. Right, so now if we must be able to finish the work, that's your fifth point. The firm should have technical, the firm should have financial, and the firm should have other resources to do what? To complete the development work. Mark that, very important. You must have the proper resources to complete the development work. If you do not have resources to complete the development work, then your development is of no use. Kyunki jab tak wo khatam nahi hoga, na aap asset bech paoge, na aap usko internally use kar paoge. So it is very important that you must have resources to complete the development work. And last point, of course, aapko intangible create karna hai, to uski cost milni chahiye. Aur cost mein kya hota hai? Jitna expenditure aapne kiya hai, wo aapke pas clearly hona chahiye. And that's your sixth point, which says expenditure incurred can be measured reliably. So whatever expenditure you are incurring, you should be in a position to measure that expenditure reliably. Are you getting it? Again, let's quickly revise the entire concept. We began with residual value. According to AS 26, a residual value of the intangible will always be nil. However, it will not be nil if any third party has committed to purchase the asset under a binding contract of sale, or there is an active secondary market where the residual value can be estimated reliably. Then we understood the concept of research and development. Any expenditure for research will straight away go to the profit and loss account. However, what is development? It is application of research findings to plan and design the new business techniques. Development expenditure can be capitalized only if all the following six conditions are satisfied. First, technical feasibility has been established. Second, firm has the intention to use or sell the asset. Third, firm has the ability to use or sell the asset. fourth, there should be a market for the final product or the intangible asset. Or if it is to be used internally, its usefulness should be demonstrated. Sirf kaam shuru karne se asset develop nahi hogi. Firm should have the technical, financial and other resources to do what? To complete the development work. And finally, expenditure incurred should be measured reliably. Right, look at the next two key points. Then we take your doubts on this. Key points, dhyan dena. First, during the course of development, matlab development jab chal raha hai tab, during the course of development, if any of the six conditions are not satisfied, important, underline, not satisfied. जब आपने डेवलपमेंट शुरू किया तब सारी सिक्स कंडीशन सेटिस्फाई हो रही थी. अब जब आप डेवलपमेंट करना शुरू कर रहे हो, अब आपको पता चल रहा है कि एक कंडीशन सेटिस्फाई नहीं हो रही है और इट सीजेस टू बी फुलफिल्ड. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, द एंटायर एक्सपेंडिचर शल बी इमीडिएटली चार्ज टू द प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट. मतलब अगर एक भी कंडीशन बीच में सेटिस्फाई होना बंद हो जाती है, देन एंटायर एक्सपेंडिचर विल स्ट्रेट अवे गो टू द प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट. राइट, नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. कोई ऐसा आर्ग्यू कर सकता है कि सर मैं डेवलपमेंट फेज में आ गया हूँ, जब मैं रिसर्च फेज में था तब गारंटी नहीं था, पर अब जब मैं डेवलपमेंट फेज में आ गया हूँ अब तो गारंटी है कि ये इंटेंजिबल बनेगा, तो जो मैंने रिसर्च पीएनएल में डेबिट किया है क्या मैं अब उसको फिर से कैपिटलाइज कर सकता हूँ? मतलब मैंने जो पीएनएल में डेबिट किया है रिसर्च एक्सपेंस, क्योंकि आपने ही कहा था एवरी रिसर्च एक्सपेंस विल गो टू द पीएनएल. व्हाई? बिकॉज एट दैट टाइम देयर इज नो गारंटी. However, now when I have done the development, the question is, can I reverse the research expense already charged to P&L and can I capitalize? The answer is no, you cannot do that. Any research or development expenditure which is already charged to revenue cannot be subsequently capitalized to create an intangible asset. So you cannot now create an intangible asset. Wo jo P&L mein research debit ho gaya, usko wapas aap reverse nahi kar sakte. Right, now it is also important to understand why they have said this. Now the logic is that suppose aaj mujhe pata chal gaya ki research successful hai, lekin aaj mere paas paise nahi hai, main 2 saal baad usko develop karta hu, to 2 saal baad main 2 saal purane expenses bar bar change nahi kar paunga. So the accounting standard board said once an expenditure goes to the profit and loss account pertaining to research, you cannot ever reverse it. It will always be a revenue expenditure which is debited to the profit and loss account. Are you understanding? One more important reason is ke research ke baad jab development shuru hota hai to all six conditions satisfy hone ke baad hi wo capitalize hoga. All six conditions satisfy ho tab tak bhi wo kahan jayega? Profit and loss account mein jayega, kyunki tab tak bhi wo P&L mein jayega. Aapko pata nahi hai six conditions kab satisfy hogi, to aap bar bar purane expenditure ko reverse nahi kar sakte. Isliye ek simple rule bana hai, any research and development expenditure which is already charged to revenue will not be subsequently capitalized to create an intangible asset. Are you clear with that? Right, so your two points are, during the course of development, if any of the six conditions are not satisfied, then the entire expenditure will be charged to revenue. Any research or development expenditure already charged to revenue cannot be subsequently capitalized to create an intangible asset. Right, that brings you to the end of this important part. So quickly, everyone on the chat box, are you absolutely clear with research and development? So that we can now go to the questions based on research and development. So quickly check and put on your chat box. Are you clear with this? Are you absolutely clear with this? Yes or no? Everyone on your chat box. Quickly, everyone on the chat box, I'm waiting for your responses. This is a very important concept, so please everyone tell me, are you clear with this? Okay, I have some doubts. Let me take that first. One doubt is, in point number one, entire expenditure means net of amount of capitalized. Okay, Shifa, if you can please properly explain this to me, I cannot understand what you have written. You are saying in point number one, but in point number one of the key points or point number one? Are you talking about point number one of the key points? Okay, key point, point number one, there is no net off. Six conditions satisfy hogi, uske baad aap capitalize karna shuru karoge. Six conditions tak ye expenditure seedha PNL mein chale jayega. Right? So I hope, Shifa, that clears your doubt. You will capitalize after the sixth condition is satisfied. Uske baad jo bhi expenditure hoga, wo aap capitalize karenge. Right, so that one doubt, I guess, is done. Oh, there was one more doubt. When will we capitalize? When all the conditions are fulfilled? Yes, of course. When all the conditions are fulfilled. Then I have one more doubt which says the intangible asset will need 5 years for completion. And in the third year, the one of the conditions ceases. And we have to capitalize second year. So we have to reverse the effect. Of course, Pushti, you will have to reverse the effect in that case. So you will provide a reversal effect. You will de-recognize the intangible that you have created, and it will straight away go to the profit and loss account. Right. So I hope, Pushti, that solves your doubt. Okay. So quickly on the chat box, Akshay, Aman, Anjali, Aksa, Bhavin, Dipesh, Dikesh, Harshit, are you clear with this? Quickly on the chat box, Ishika, Jalpan, Khushi, Manav, Mukaddisha, Om, Pavan, Pushti, Raghav, Raj, Riya, Rizwan, Rohan, Shifa, Shreyas, Shruti, Simran, Spruha, Shrushti, Tulsi, Yash, Devnani, Yash Devani and Yash Patel. Are you all clear with this? Okay, excellent. If you're clear with this, let's go to one interesting question now. Okay, I have one more doubt which says demonstrated means prove. Demonstrated means show, exhibit, or prove. Right, Akshay, I hope that solves your doubt. Demonstrated means show, exhibit, or prove. Right. Now, quickly help me. According to me, question number one is done. Question number two is also done. Question number three. Now, question number three. I will read the question and you will tell me what is the correct answer. Okay. I'm reading the question. Please pay attention. It says, AB Limited launched a project for producing product X in October 2009. The company incurred rupees 20 lakhs towards research and development expenses up to 31st March 2011. Due to prevailing market conditions, the management came to a conclusion that the product cannot be manufactured and sold in the market for the next 10 years. Okay, everyone on the chat box. Since this question covers both research and development, can you tell me development ki kaun si condition yahan pe satisfy nahi ho rahi hai? Can you tell me on the chat box which condition is not getting satisfied? Everyone on your chat box, which condition is not getting satisfied? Please read the question carefully and tell me. Look at the conditions and tell me. The fourth condition says that there should be a market for the final product where you can sell. But here they are saying that it cannot be sold. It says the product cannot be manufactured and sold for the next 10 years. Now tell me, since condition number four is not getting satisfied, quickly on the chat box, can we capitalize this expenditure? Yes or no? No. If we cannot capitalize, where will this expenditure go? If we cannot capitalize, Where will this expenditure go? Of course, it will go to the profit and loss account, right? So let's see what they've given. Karna kya hai question mein? Look at the question. What have they asked you? Advise the company as per the applicable accounting standard. Okay, let's understand this. As per accounting standard 26, intangible assets, expenditure on research should be recognized as an expense when it is incurred. An intangible asset arising from development or from the development phase of internal product should be recognized if and only if an enterprise can demonstrate all the conditions specified in the standard. The intangible asset arising from development should be derecognized when no future economic benefits are expected from its use according to the standard. Therefore, the manager cannot defer the expenditure write-off to future years. The expense amounting to rupees 20 lakhs incurred on research and development should be written off in the current year ending 31st March 2011. So entire expenditure will be charged to the profit and loss account. Right, okay. That was a very simple question. Question number three, we have done. Leave question number four, question number five as of now. Come to question number six on page number 177. Question number six on page 177. Question number six on page 177. Let's read that question and understand it. It says M Limited launched a project for producing product A in November 2008. The company incurred rupees 30 lakhs towards research and development expenses up to 31st March 2010. Due to unfavorable market conditions, the management feels that it is not possible to manufacture and sell the product in the market for the next so many years. The management hence wants to defer the expenditure write-off to future years. Tell me, can the management defer this expenditure to future years? Yes or no? Can the management defer this expenditure to future years? Question is yes or no. Quickly on the chat box. Of course not. The management cannot defer this expenditure to the future years. Since the management cannot defer this expenditure to future years, where will it go? Everyone on your chat box, where will it go? It will of course go to the profit and loss account. Okay, let's quickly see the solution. Karna kya hai question mein, advise the company as per the applicable accounting standard. So we'll have to explain that since the conditions for research and development are not satisfied, this expenditure will straight away go to the profit and loss account. Right, see what they've given. As per accounting standard 26, intangible assets, expenditure on research should be recognized as an expense when it is incurred. An intangible asset arising from development or from the development phase of an internal project should be recognized if and only if an enterprise can demonstrate all the conditions specified in the standard. An intangible asset should be de-recognized when no future economic benefits are expected from its use according to AS 26. Therefore, the management, underline, cannot defer the expenditure write-off to future years, and the company is required to expense the entire amount of 30 lakhs in the profit and loss account for the year ended 31st March 2010. Right, so again a simple question, but mark this important last day revision question. Mark question number six, important and last day revision question. Mark question number six, important and your last day revision question. Mark question number six, important, last day revision question. Okay, question number seven, we will do later. Question number eight, we are done. Question number nine, also we are done. Question number 10 and 11, we will do a bit later. Question number 12, we are done. Question number 13 also we are done. Question number 15 also I guess we are done. Have we done question number 15 on the chat box? Yes or no? Have we done question number 15? Have we done question number 15? Yes or no? Okay, what about question number 16? Have we done that? Have we done question number 16? Yes, okay, great. Question number 16 we have done. 17 also we have done. Question number 18. Okay. 19 is left. 20 and 21. Okay. Come to question number 21. Let's solve question number 21. Quickly on question number 21, which is on page number 190. Question 21, page number 190. Question number 21, page number 190. Okay, let's begin. K Limited launched a project for producing product X in October 2015. The company incurred rupees 40 lakhs towards research and development expenses up to 31st March 2016. Due to prevailing market conditions, the management came to know that the product cannot be manufactured and sold in the market for the next 10 years. The management wants to defer the expenditure right off to future years. Advise the company as per the applicable AS. So quickly on the chat box, what will you do with this? How will you treat this expenditure of rupees 40 lakhs? Quickly on the chat box, how will you treat this expenditure of rupees 40 lakhs? It will go to the profit and loss account. Can you defer it? Yes or no? Can you defer it? Yes or no? Of course not. You cannot defer it. Let's look at the solution. It says, as per AS 26, intangible assets, expenditure on research and research should be recognized as an expense when it is incurred. An intangible asset arising from development or from the development phase of an internal project should be recognized if and only if the enterprise can demonstrate all the conditions specified in the standard. An intangible asset arising from development should be de-recognized when no future economic benefits are expected from its use. Thus, the manager cannot defer the expenditure right off to future years in the given case. Hence, the expense amounting to rupees 40 lakhs incurred on research and development project has to be written off in the current year ending 31st March 2016. Right, I hope that is absolutely clear to you. You will straight away charge it to the profit and loss account. Right, okay. Quickly on your chat box, just confirm one thing to me. I am writing over there which are now our pending questions. Just quickly tell me if I'm missing something. Question number 4 is yet to be done. Question number 5 is yet to be done. Question number 6 we have done. Question number 7 is yet to be done. Question number 8 and 9 we have done. 10 and 11 is yet to be done. After that, you have question number 12, which we have done. 13, we have done. Question number 14 is something that we need to do. 15th and 16th, we have done. 17 also we have done. So 17 also we have done. Question number 18 is yet to be done. Then question number 19 and 20 is to be done. Quickly confirm on the chat box. Are these the ones which are pending? Yes or no? Are these the ones which are yet to be done? Okay, perfect. Then we are left with 9 questions. Fine, okay. Now, what you do is you take a 10 minutes break. Since we have been constantly doing theory concepts, take a 10 minutes break, and then we go to, we try and do two practical questions based on research and development, right? So quickly take a 10 minutes break. Right now it is 9:01. We will again meet at 9:10 sharp. So take a quick 10 minutes break, and then we continue with two interesting questions based on research and development, right? So see you at 9:10. Okay, let's continue. Come to question number 14. Come to question number 14. Question number 14 on page number 185. Please understand the question carefully and mark this question, question number 14, very important, last day revision question. Mark question number 14, very important, last day revision question. You have question number 14, page number 185. This question is your important last day revision question. Okay, dhyan dena karna kya hai question. Messrs. Mahesh Limited is developing a new product production process. During the financial year ended 31st March 2013, the total expenditure incurred was 60 lakhs. So total kharcha kitna hua hamara 60 lakhs. The production process met the recognition criteria of intangible asset on 1st December 2012. So 1st December 2012 ko hamari sari 6 ki 6 condition satisfied hui. और हमारा टोटल खर्चा आज तक कितना हुआ है 60 लाख ओके एवरीवन अंडरस्टैंड दिस केयरफुली टोटल एक्सपेंडिचर इज 60 राइट सो वी विल हैव टू प्रिपेयर अ प्रॉपर अंडरस्टैंड प्रिपेयर अ प्रॉपर डायग्राम टू एक्सप्लेन टू यू Okay, quickly on the chat box, total expenditure 60 hai, till the conditions were satisfied, kitna kharcha hua? Everyone on the chat box, till the conditions are getting satisfied, how much expenditure have you all made? ₹32 lakhs, okay, so till we satisfy the conditions, my expenditure is ₹32 lakhs. ओके टेल मी अगर 60 में से 32 टिल द कंडीशंस आर सैटिस्फाइड है तो बाकी का एक्सपेंडिचर कितना बचा 28 लाख ओके यू हैव 28 लाख ओके टेल मी हाउ विल यू ट्रीट 32 हाउ विल यू ट्रीट 28 क्विकली हाउ विल यू ट्रीट 32 हाउ विल यू ट्रीट 32 लाख विल गो टू द प्रॉफिट and loss account. Everyone agrees it will go to the profit and loss account. Very good. What about 28? What will happen to 28? You will capitalize 28 lakhs. Easy hai? Okay, chalo, aage badhte hai. It says, the production process met the definition criteria for recognition of an intangible asset on 1st December. Expenditure incurred till that date was 32. Further expenditure incurred on the process for the financial year ending 31st March 2014 was 90 lakhs. Matlab, itna kharcha karne ke baad aur extra kharcha humne kitna kiya? 90 lakhs. Tell me everyone on your chat box, how will you treat this 90 lakhs? Where will you treat this 90 lakhs? जो एडिशनल 90 लाख का खर्चा हुआ है हाउ विल यू ट्रीट इट विल यू चार्ज इट टू पीएनएल और विल यू कैपिटलाइज ऑफ कोर्स 90 लाख विल बी कैपिटलाइज सो आई एम राइटिंग ओवर हियर 90 लाख फर्दर एक्सपेंडिचर will be capitalized. Right, okay, आगे बढ़ते हैं, ध्यान देना. Further expenditure will be capitalized of 90 lakhs. Can you tell me what is the total value of your asset now, intangible asset? Everyone on your chat box, what's your total value of intangible asset as of now? Total intangible asset कितने का हुआ? Ishika, can you explain how 150? Ishika, can you explain how 150? Ishika, Shifa or Aksa, anyone, can you explain to me how 150? Okay, Ishika, if you say 90 plus 60, did you capitalize the entire 60, Ishika? Did you capitalize the entire expenditure? Did you capitalize the entire expenditure? No. How much did you capitalize then? How much did you capitalize? 32. So then you cannot add the entire 60. So you did not capitalize 32. You capitalized 28. 32 went to the profit and loss account. How much did you capitalize? You capitalized 28. Yes, you capitalized 28 plus 90. So basically it will be 28 plus 90. Will be the amount that you will capitalize, right? So you capitalize 118 in total. Ab dekho aage question mein kya hua, dhyan dena. Interesting point. Next point, it says, as on 31st March 2014, the recoverable account of know-how embodied in the process is estimated to be 82 lakhs. Matlab aapne jo 118 lakh rupaye ka intangible create kiya, उसकी वैल्यू घट के अब कितनी हो गई, 82 लाख. दिस इंक्लूड्स द एस्टिमेट ऑफ फ्यूचर कैश इनफ्लोज एंड आउटफ्लोज बोथ. करना क्या है क्वेश्चन में, ध्यान देना, एक ही क्वेश्चन में हमसे चार क्वेश्चन पूछे हैं उन्होंने. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट एक्सपेंडिचर इज टू बी चार्ज टू प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट फॉर द ईयर एंडिंग 31st March 2013. ये रहा, फॉर द ईयर एंडिंग 31st March 2013 द टोटल एक्सपेंडिचर वॉज 60 लाख. 31st March 2013 के बाद first December को you met the definition criteria. So tell me the answer to the first question. How much expenditure will be charged to P&L for the year ended 31st March 2013? Quickly on the chat box. How much expenditure will be charged to the profit and loss account? Of course, 32 lakhs will be charged to the profit and loss account. Right, so let's put that over here. Solution to the first one, you will put rupees 32 lakhs will be recognized as an expenditure to the profit and loss account as it does not meet the definition criteria of accounting standard 26. Right? So first answer is that it does not meet the definition criteria. So 32 lakhs will go to the profit and loss account. Right, I hope that is absolutely clear and easy. Come to the second one. Everyone on your chat box, the carrying amount, what is the carrying amount of intangible on 31st March 2013? Same date pe aapse carrying amount bhi pooch rahe. Tell me, kitna aega aapka carrying amount? You get 28 lakhs. Kaise mila 28 lakhs? Ye raha. 60 minus 32. So let's put this properly. Point two, rupees 28 lakhs will be capitalized as this amount expended meets the definition criteria of Accounting Standard 26. How did you get 28 lakhs? We have explained over here. So 28 lakhs will be capitalized as an asset. Okay, two question, bahut easy. The third question, what is the expenditure to be charged to the profit and loss account for the year ended 31st March 2014? This we will have to solve. So three. Amount be charged to profit and loss account for the year ended. So 31st March 2014. Let's prepare our format for that. You have particulars over here, you have amount, you will have rupees in lakhs, okay. What's your carrying amount? Let's begin solving this. Carrying amount on 31st March 2013. Kitna humne capitalized kiya? 28 lakhs. So we capitalized 28 lakhs. Uske baad further expenditure question mein dekhiye kitna hai? Further expenditure. Is how much? 90 lakhs? So 90. What's your book value of intangible? 118. ये जो 118 book value है इसके सामने रिकवरेबल अमाउंट कितना दिया हुआ है क्वेश्चन में? 82. Everyone on the chat box, has our value of intangible reduced or increased? Has our value of intangible in the question reduced or increased? Reduced. Reduced by how much? Reduced by how much? 36. So 36 lakhs is known as impairment loss. Impairment loss means reduction in value of the asset. Your useful value of the asset is less and book value is more. That is known as impairment loss. Which comes to 36 lakhs. So impairment loss will be 36 lakhs. this rupees 36 lakhs will be charged to profit and loss account for the year ending 31st March 2014. Rupees 36 lakhs will be charged to profit and loss account. Right, look at the fourth one. What have they asked you in the fourth one? What is the carrying amount of the intangible on 31st March 2014? So let's find out the carrying amount of the intangible on 31st March 2014. Your carrying amount of the intangible on 31st March 2014. Let's calculate that. It's a very simple calculation that you have to now make. What's your book value? Your book value is 118. Against that, what's your impairment loss? Impairment loss in the question is 36. So your carrying amount on 31st March 2014 will be 118 minus 36 comes to 82 lakhs. Your carrying amount will be 82 lakhs. Right, very good question to understand, very good question to practice. I will quickly put this on your WhatsApp group. Please ensure that you copy it properly. In the meantime, if you have any doubts, let's solve that. Just give me a minute, I'll put it on the chat box so that you can properly copied. Till then, if you have any doubts, please quickly post it on the chat box. Only if you are thoroughly clear, only if you understand, then you copy. Do not simply copy without understanding. Okay, so you have the entire solution on your official WhatsApp group. take it down quickly. If you have any doubts, please post it on the chat box. Quickly take down the entire solution. If you have any doubts, please ask me. If you're done copying, please mention done on the chat box so that we can proceed. Take it down quickly. Once you're done copying, please put on the chat box that you're done so that we move to the next question. Are you done with this? Yes or no? Done copying this question? Any doubts in this question? Any doubts in this question? if you are done with this question, let's do one last question for today. And let us try and solve. Let me look for a good question. Yes, let's try and solve question number 18. Come to question number 18. Let's quickly do question number 18 on page number 188. Okay, I will solve the question first. You will understand the concept carefully. Then if you understand, only then you will copy. If you don't understand, you will ask me. I will explain to you only when you're convinced, only when you're thoroughly clear, then you will copy. Right, come to question number 18. Good question. Now, question number 18 is a combination of AS26 and AS5. Dono question inhone combine kiye. Dono accounting standard ke concepts inhone combine karke question banaya hai, isliye dhyan dena. It says ABC Limited developed a know-how by incurring an expenditure of 20 lakhs. The know-how was used by the company from 1/4/2008. The useful life of the asset is 10 years, commencing from the year of commencement of its use. The company has not amortized the asset till 31st March 2012. Quickly on the chat box. Kitne saal tak humne amortization provide nahi kiya hai? How many years have gone by? Quickly on the chat box. Kitne saal beet gaye aur humne ek bar bhi amortization provide nahi kiya? Everyone agrees 7 years? Okay. Perfect. 7 years. Now tell me, is it error or omission? Tell me, error or omission? Is it error or omission? Right, so error means you made a mistake. And omission means you did not record it. So Raj, is it an error or omission? Error means आपने record तो किया लेकिन गलत record किया. Omission means आपने record ही नहीं किया. So my question to you, Raj, is error or omission now? Omission, okay. Tell me, will error or omission lead to prior period item? Right, and accounting standard 5 says that any prior period item should be recognized in the year in which you detect it. Okay, aage padhte hain. Karna kya hai humko question mein? Pass journal entry to give effect of value of know-how as per accounting standard 26. So journal entry in the books of ABC Limited. Let's put that. Journal entry in the books of ABC Limited. Let's prepare our format quickly. We have particulars, debit and credit. Value will be in rupees. Prepare a systematic format. You need to pass only one journal entry, so please not prepare a bigger format. You need a small format sufficient for one journal entry. Okay, now before we pass the journal entry, I want you to help me out with this entry. Tell me, we have not amortized. So when we will amortize, we will have to debit the profit and loss account, right? Yes or no? Will we debit the profit and loss account or create the profit and loss account? Since we have to amortize, will we debit the P&L or create the P&L? Okay. So we will debit the profit and loss account. So I'm writing over here, profit and loss account will be debited. Profit and loss, but since it is an omission, I'm writing over here, prior period item. Prior period item. Okay. Can you tell me कि टोटल हमने 7 years का omission किया है, but how much out of 7 years will be prior period item? Can someone think properly and tell me how much of this 7 years will be your prior period item? 6 years only, क्योंकि 7th year तो current year है, वहाँ पे तो कोई omission हुआ नहीं है, current year तो हम provide कर रहे हैं. So 6 years का information will be prior period item. Okay. Look at the question and tell me how much will be your amortization per annum? Amortization per annum will be 2 lakhs into 6 years you get 12 lakhs 2 lakhs into 6 years you will have 12 lakhs amortization account will also be debited by how much? 2 lakhs to know-how account. How much? 14 lakhs. So to know how will be 14 lakhs. Your narration being amortization provided for 7 years, of which 6 years provided as a prior period item. Take this down properly. If you have any doubts, please ask me. break it down properly. If you have any doubts, please ask me. Are you done with this quickly on your chat box? Right. So simple question it was, where you have past 6 years as your prior period item and amortization of 2 lakhs for the current year. Right. Okay. I believe this much is sufficient for today. So do go back today and revise the entire concept. If you have any doubts, please get back to me and I shall solve it for you. I will now see you next time whenever my lecture is, depending on when the material, when the schedule has been given. And then accordingly, we will continue. And I think in the next lecture, we will be in a position to finish off Accounting Standard 26. So please ensure that your Accounting Standard 26 is also completed along with me. And if you have any doubts, please get back to me. By that time, I have one doubt which says why depreciation account has been debited. So basically, you can call it either depreciation or amortization. You can call it either of them for amortization of an intangible. So that is why they have used the word depreciation. You can use depreciation. You can use amortization. Any of these you can use. Right, Spru? I hope that solves your doubt. Okay. Thank you so much for attending. Raj, if you check your text, I have replied to your doubt. If you quickly go back to the chat history, you will find that your doubt has been replied to. Okay, fine. Thank you. Thank you so much for attending. I will now see you next time. Please revise the entire accounting standard, whatever we have done. Right. Thank you and bye.